Good morning, children. I'm back again with the second part of From the Diary of Anne Frank. In the first part, you write the situation in which all these Jews were there, and then you also came to know why she wanted to write the diary. And then the next part, she also told about herself, which is really needed for you to understand who is Anne Frank and why she gave that much importance to Kitty. Yes, children, this is the diary what she wrote. From this, we are going to know about her feelings and about her in a better way. Now, she started writing the diary Saturday, 20th June 1942. Now, did you see that? She went into the hiding camp in the month of July. So, at this time, she was really a free girl going to school. So, after that, went into the hiding place. They never went to school. They never went to any markets, they didn't step out of the house, like our lockdown period. So now this is what she wrote. Dearest Kitty, our entire class is quacking in its boots. The reason, of course, is the forthcoming meeting in which the teachers decide who will move up to the next form and who will be kept back. Half of the class is making beds. GN and I laugh ourselves silly at the two boys behind us, CN and Jacques, who have staked their entire holiday savings on their bet. From morning to night, it's, you are going to pass. No, I'm not. Yes, you are. No, I'm not. Even G's pleading glances and my angry outbursts can't calm them down. If you ask me, there are so many dummies that about a quarter of the class should be kept back. But teachers are the most unpredictable creatures on the earth. So look at that, what she wrote. So our entire class is quacking in boots. Quacking in boots, which means shaking with fear and are very nervous. So why are they nervous? What is the reason for that? Quacking its boots. Actually meaning is, if you take true words, it is like making some sound in the boots. That means that is not the expression. That is called as idiomatic expression. If you take true meaning of each and every word in that phrase, it's not going to give you proper meaning. This is called as idiom. Okay. Now, in this paragraph, what happened? The teachers are going to have a meeting. In that meeting, they are going to decide who are the students who passed and will go to next class and who will be there in the same class. So there are, will my name be there? Will I go to the next class? Or will I be there in the same class? They are all worried about that. So here she told GN, CN and all that, because maybe she did not like to reveal the names. And so she just kept GN and CN. Maybe because that's how we call, right? With the initials. So they were just having that. What is that? Taking their entire holidays, savings, they were keeping their bet. No, you are going to pass. No, I am not going to pass. You are going to be promoted. No, you are not going to be promoted. In that way, they were continuously shouting. And G's pleadings and my angry outbursts. Hey, keep quiet. She was telling them. But even then, they could not stop because they were really very tensed. So again, look at that. If you talk about our class, there are about quarter of our class, means one fourth of the class, they must be in the same class according to Anne Frank. But you know, the teachers are unpredictable. Maybe more or less, you can't predict what, on what grounds they'll be promoting the students to the next class. I'm not so worried about my girlfriends and myself will make it. The only subject I'm not sure about is maths. Anyway, we all can do is wait. Until then, we keep telling each other not to lose heart. Lose heart. Is that really losing the heart? No. Losing the heart means stop worrying or thinking that you will not be successful. So, trust that you are going to be able to do that. We will be keep telling each other, don't lose your heart. Maybe you will pass. That's what they were about to tell. Now, here we found two idiomatic expressions. are those idioms? Idioms are, these are the common English idioms what we will be using in our day-to-day life. Cat caught your tongue. That means, is the cat really catching your tongue? No, it is, you are not able to speak. Then again, go the extra mile. That means every day walking that extra mile. No, this is actually the meaning what you think, but actually make an extra effort. Now, are we not making extra effort to reach you? Definitely we are making extra effort. So, go that extra mile to reach you. Next, butterflies in my stomach, feeling nervous. Children, who can tell that better than we teachers now, standing in front of cameras and teaching you? Yes, butterflies in our stomach were really, that we are feeling really, really nervous standing in front of the cameras. Now, once in a blue moon, very, very rarely, right? So, these are exact words, what they mean is different, and in the context, what they mean is different. Such kind of expressions are called as idioms. Yeah. I got along pretty well with all my teachers. There are 9 of them, 7 men and 2 women. Mr. Keesing, the old fogey, who teaches maths, was annoyed with me for ages because I talked so much. After several warnings, he assigned me extra work, an essay on the subject, a charter box. A charter box? What can you write about that? I would worry about that later. I decided. I jotted down the title in my notebook, tucked it in my bag, and tried to keep quiet. So, you know that. So, she is very good, comfortable with all the teachers except maths teacher. So, who was that maths teacher? Mr. Keesing, the old foggy. Foggy means old-fashioned person, like who will scold unnecessarily when you are not, when you are going with that trendy way. Why are you dressing like that? And why are you going out at this time? So, people who were grumble, old age people, they were called as old foggy. And even among your friends also, you can feel a person who are not able to mingle with other friends freely and following like old traditions and all that, you can call him old foggy. Who teaches maths was annoyed with me for ages. Okay, for ages means that is the expression which she used to tell for such a long duration, many months. Okay, now why? He was annoyed with her because I talked so much. After several warnings, he assigned me extra homework. As she was continuously talking in the class, he gave her extra work. What was that? An essay on the subject, a charter box. A charter box, right? Essay on charter box. First up, charter box, essay, same thing she got. A charter box. What can you write about that? I would worry about that later, I decided. So she just wrote the title, the topic in the book and kept that in the bag. Then what happened? That evening, after I had finished the rest of my homework, I note down the essay caught my hand. The essay caught my eye. I began thinking about the subject while chewing the tip of my fountain pen. Chewing the tip of my, is she really eating that? No, she was thinking about the topic. Now, what to write about the charter box? After completing the homework, she reminded the work given by her maths teacher. Anyone would ramble on, leave big, big spaces between the words, but the trick was to come up with convincing arguments to prove that necessity of talking. So, if the same book is given to any other student, 2 pages or 3 pages, leaving lot of space between the words and folding this side more than 1 inch and here folding that and writing in between, like the way you are writing your exams quarterly and half yearly or annual SA1 and SA2 exams, you'll be writing big, big letters, leaving a space. So that's generally anybody will do the same thing because that was the punishment what was given. But she did not want to do that. What is it she wanted to do? She wanted to write in such a way that talking is very necessary. Convincing arguments means to write in such a way that her, after reading that, the teacher should feel that yes, talking is very important for the students. So keeping that in mind, she wanted to write the essay on a charter box. Now, I thought and thought and suddenly I had an idea. I wrote the 3 pages Mr. Kissing had assigned me and was satisfied. After writing 3 pages, she got satisfied. I argued that talking is a student's trait and that I would do my best to keep it under control. But that I would never be able to cure myself of the habit since my mother talked as much as I did, if not more, and that there is not much you can do about inherited traits. So what did she wrote in that 3 pages? She wrote that I'm talking, I'm disturbing, no doubt. But what is the first thing she told? I'll try my best to keep this in my control. I want to keep it. But what is that? Her mother also talks so much. It's the trait that she inherited from her mother. So even if she tried a lot, she may not be in a position to come out of this habit of talking. Next, Mr. Kissing had a good laugh at my arguments, but when I proceeded to talk my way through the next class, he assigned me a second essay. This time, it was supposed to be on incorrigible chatterbox. I handed it in and Mr. Kissing had nothing to complain about for 2 whole lessons. However, during the 3rd lesson, he had finally had enough. Annie Frank, as punishment for talking in the class, write an essay titled Quack, 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 said Mistress Chatterbox. So, 3rd time. 2nd time, he gave her one more and incorrigible chatterbox. One who cannot be corrected. So, she wrote again and she submitted. And this time also, her teacher, Mr. Kissing, got convinced. And then, again she started talking. Again, he gave punishment. One more essay. What is that? Quack, 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 said Mistress Chatterbox. Now, on that topic, she was supposed to write a essay. Now, the class roared, started laughing. I had to laugh too, though I had never exhausted in ingenuity of the topic of chatterboxes. So, 2 essays she already wrote about chatterbox. Now, one more topic is given. She has to think a lot and write. And her mind is vacant now. All the ideas, whatever she got, she put that in the 2 essays. 3rd one, she is not able to get any idea what write. She was thinking about that. It was time to come up with something else, something original. Then my friend Sani, who is good at poetry, offered to help me write the essay from beginning to end in verse, and I jumped for joy. So she told her to write not an essay this time, to write a poem. And she really felt very happy for that idea. Mr. Kissing was trying to play a joke on me with this ridiculous subject, but I would make sure the joke was on him. So he was really trying to make fun of me. This time I am going to convert that on him again. I finished my poem and it was beautiful. It was about a mother duck and a father's son with 3 baby ducklings who were bitten to death by the father because they quacked too much. Luckily, Mr. Kissing took the joke in right way. He read the poem to the class, adding his own comments and to several other classes as well. Since then, I have been allowed to talk and haven't been assigned any extra homework. On the contrary, Mr. Kissing's always making jokes these days. So she finished the poem and it came really very nice. And then it was about, what is the poem she wrote about? It was about a mother duck and father swan, and they have 3 baby ducks. Ducklings means babies, who were bitten to death by father because they were quacking a lot. They quacked too much. Luckily, this teacher, Mr. Kissing, did not get angry on Anne Frank, but he took that joke in a right way. He read the poem to the class, adding his own comments, and then he did not stop there. He took that poem even to the other classes as well. Then, since then, I have been allowed to talk. So he did not stop her from talking in the class and haven't been assigned any extra homework. Did not even give extra homework to her. But on the contrary, he started always cracking jokes in the class and make the class really very lively. So this is the first diary what she wrote about. Here is again oral comprehension. Why was Mr. Kissing annoyed with Annie? What did he ask her to do? So you have to write why Mr. Kissing was angry and what was the punishment given to her. And how did Annie justify her being a chatterbox in her essay? Okay. And then, do you think Mr. Kissing was a strict person in the beginning? Yes, he was. Then, what made Mr. Kissing allow Annie to talk in the class? The way she convinced him with that poem. Okay. Go back and read the lesson if you have any doubts in that. Okay. Now, children, before you leave, I just want to give you, in your textbook after the lesson, there were 7 questions which you need to write, and then there was one more work, phrasal verbs and idioms, expressions were there in that. So complete even that. I think you can do that if you read the lesson properly and know what are the phrasal verbs. Okay, do that even that work also. We will meet again in the virtual class. Thank you.